players enter the arena and onto court one for the third men's singles quarterfinal. It's a match between Zhang Yika there in black and Wang Lichin in red. And we'll let the MC introduce the players to the crowd.
And from the Netherlands, Thijs van Veen.
So the players now on their way back to their corners. And again, as in the previous quarterfinal, there'll be no coaches in action as we have an all-Chinese affair. Zhang Yika there, ranked number 3 in the world. And Wang Lichin ranked at number 9. Of course, Wang Lichin previously been at number 1. Indeed, he's won the men's singles title at the World Championships on 3 occasions, 2001, 2005 and 2007. And indeed, he was runner-up 2 years ago in Yokohama. So an incredible record for Wang Lichin in the World Championships. He won a bronze medal in the men's singles in the Olympics in Athens and Beijing. 3 times winner of the World Cup. And the winner, would you believe, of 23 ITTF Pro Tour events. He won as early as 1998 in Lebanon. And the last one was in Qatar in 2010. So the senior pro, 32 years of age, 3 times former world champion, Wang Lichin. There he is doing some last minute stretches. Right-handed topspin player. Has a rocket forehand topspin. And no one can question his record at the World Championships over recent years. Zhang Yika. His opponent, quite incredibly, Richard, has never actually played in the World Championships before in men's singles. And it's amazing for a player, number 3 in the world. This is his debut in the men's singles event. So, but he did win the runner-up in the World Cup recently in Magdeburg when he lost to Wang Hao in the final. Runner-up in the Asian Championships in 2009, but he did, and I'm sad to tell you this, Richard, but you were there. He beat Timo Boll, of course, in the final of the German Open recently Dortmund.
Yeah, I mean, Zhang Yika was really upcoming together with Xu Xin, and what surprised me throughout when I follow his matches is his unbelievable strong backhand. Usually Chinese, the shakehand grip, you have a little bit more this tendency to use his forehand. But we will see this throughout the match. He will also open the game a little bit more with the backhand flick, and he relies very much on this backhand side, and using the forehand also very strong. But not only, he's like really a both wing player, and probably he loves to play backhand a bit more even than he likes to play forehand.
Interesting statistic on screen there. They've played 4 times. It's 2 each. And the last time they met was at the ITTF Pro Tour event in the United Arab Emirates a few months ago. And on that occasion, Wang beat Zhang 4-1 in the quarterfinal. I guess if you were one of the Chinese coaches looking to London 2012, the ideal result would be Zhang Yika to win, because at 32, if Wang Lichin wins, it throws a new dimension into the whole selection issue.
But seems to me a little bit like Wang Lichin is really never losing track. I mean, yesterday he took out already Xu Xin. If he takes out the second young gun, Zhang Yika, then I think Liu Liang might even start thinking a little bit different way. But to be honest, usually also for the Chinese team, it's about time to bring some younger player in the right position, because it's always a little bit extra pressure. Like these players, they not have to play well, they have to win titles, they have to win gold medals.
But I'm sure Wang Lichin would love nothing more than to put that problem on the table of Liu Guliang.
Definitely.
I'm the current world champion. Are you going to pick me? Yeah. He'd love to do it. And there he is. He's done it three times already. He was runner-up 2 years ago.
First game.
Didn't manage to win the Olympic title. Two bronze medals in singles. But we're now ready to go. And it's Zhang Yike to serve at the start of the first game. Good topspin from Zhang. We mentioned that Wang had a superb victory against Zhu Xin 4-1 in the round of last 16. Zhang Yike played Josie Hook, the defensive player from the Republic of Korea. Do you often feel that if you've played a defensive player, it can throw you out of your stride a little bit the round before? It's a completely different game.
I think if you have one day in between, it's not that big problem. It's sometimes if you have this different time schedule that you have to play some hours later, then you might feel really you have lost a little bit the rhythm there. But I think these athletes, if they have one day time to recover, to really adjust all the techniques, because they are a little bit different to play against defense than to play against attack players, I think Zhang Yike won't feel any trouble. Maybe he feels a bit in the arm, but it's, I think, not troubling him too much.
Zhang Yike leads 2-1, and it's Wang Lichin with his second serve. Wang Lichin looking for the angle out wide to Zhang's forehand, just misses, 3-1. Zhang Yike leads. Two right-handed shake-hand grip players. Some of the Chinese players coaching, the sports staff that you mentioned, Richard, the yep. coaches, the physios, the doctors, they're here in force, and they always impress me as a well-run, well-managed unit.
See, now a little bit from the service of Zhang Yike. Should throw up, throw the ball like straight up. Still in the right rhythm at this moment for Wang Yichin, missing two times, three times with forehand. Usually if he once comes to forehand, it's so difficult to stop him. He still has maybe like this extra, this special forehand swing. We saw yesterday also with Xu Xin, once he started with forehand, really was no way to stop him.
Backhand down the line. I think that was a side, personally, but I'd like to see the action replay.
Yep. Touched, but I'm not sure if it's up or down.
Here we go. Let's have a look. Could well be that Wang Lichin standing in the way, but here it goes. Down the line. Next one, I think. I'm going for side. I'm not sure what the umpire did. He did the same. Yeah. He did the same.
Yeah.
So, good decision, we think. Zhang Yike now leads 6-1. Good start.
And there we saw like what I said in the beginning, like have coming again with his backhand flick, opening the game, trying to look for this backhand against Wang Lichin, where he for sure is the better player in comparison. Also yesterday, Wang Yichin did play very, very good with the backhand, especially with his passive game against Xu Xin. Was very good. He really improved backhand there.
Six, three.
Zhang Yike with the topspin into the body of Wang. 7-3.
Nicely. Took all advantage also of his length to really put everything inside. Nice ankle there. Missing a bit too much, has problem in adapting. Racket is a little bit low, too much off the table right now.
You just wonder whether he's, I mean, clearly he's massively experienced, but sometimes I think when players are a little bit tense, they tend to do that, get a lot of neck cords. Yep. They're just not quite relaxed enough, haven't got the rhythm. And maybe once he settles in, we'll see a lot more consistency with the forehand topspin. Good backhand topspin, then the forehand. And again, that little bit of side spin, just to take it out wider. Backhand flick just off the end of the table.
Opening again from even short forehand with the backhand. But in this cross court, Wang Yiqing usually is really so dominant to all of the players still.
Backhand to backhand, Zhang Yike, forehand to forehand, Wang Yiqing the favorite.
And he stepped back a little bit, using like a little bit of bigger backhand swing there, like nearly in the half distance. So it gives him a little bit more time to accelerate, not only to stay backhand close to the table.
Serve drifted long. Wang Yiqing in with the forehand topspin, slowly but surely. Wang is narrowing the gap. Switch down the line, paid dividends for Wang, 9 points each. Wang Yiqing can win this, it'd be quite a blow for Zhang Yike.
And looks like he's not afraid of playing backhand to Zhang Yike. He's really improved this backhand, he's really more stable with backhand, he's not having to turn around all the time using his better back forehand than backhand. But he's so far, also in the match yesterday, Susin, very, very good playing with his backhand.
Some of the old Dutch players there watching, Danny Heister, Paul Howland. Zhang Yike with game point. And the flick off the end of the table. You could see how much that meant to Zhang Yike. Shouted with delight. I don't think I've seen as much emotion from him after winning a game, but it almost slipped away.
Yeah. He felt like Wang Yiqing starts to find the rhythm better, and maybe Zhang Yike also was a bit nervous because he knows, like, if he's winning the first game, he will settle down, he will calm down a little bit from inside. So this is always very, very important. Whenever also any European or any other nation is playing, it's a Chinese player. Like, if you take the first game, they're not that calm and they're not that superior. So this is, of course, the same if two Chinese meet each other.
The crowd enjoying themselves, and why not? Lively music here in between the games. The other interesting thing, Richard, I didn't watch the game between Wang Yiqing and Zhu Xin. I was commentating on another game at the same time. But I watched Wang Yiqing play Zhu Xin in England in the Pro Tour event earlier this year. And there was a lot of looking at each other, the fist. There was, you know, there was certainly a psychological battle going on there. And I saw that there as well. Clearly, Wang Yiqing is highly motivated to try and beat the young players.
Yeah, for sure. And Zhu Xin got a little bit nervous. It was 1-1, 6-2 in the third one. 2-6-3 in the fourth, and Zhu Xin didn't could get back that game to win that whole match. And this was so much credit of Wang Yiqing, the way he was playing there. We'll see what the second young gun is doing.
I just get the feeling that the point I made before about him wanting to give Liu Guoliang the problem of, I'm the world champion, are you going to pick me? I think he really desperately, I know it's obvious to say you want to win the world, but I think he really wants to cause that problem. Yeah. He's determined.
And I see him still, if he's practicing now, we mentioned that he was, there were some days in the Schlager Academy, like Wang Yichen was practicing really another extra time. Then after practice was finished, he went up in the power room to lift some extra weight. So he's really in a very brilliant athletic condition altogether.
So from what you're saying, the facilities at the Werner Schlager Academy are outstanding. Training facilities, living facilities.
Yeah, and we have, okay, like we need to use the hotels in Schwechat around, but like for practice itself, inside the hall, we have 36 tables. We have room for weight practice. We have restaurants inside. It's really a good place to be.
And players from other countries can come along and they just contact the Werner Schlager Academy and they can come and train.
Exactly. And we are really growing. The group is already on quite good level and we still want to grow because it's a very, very good idea behind to really help all Europe in order to improve. And maybe not only Europe, but like all nations that are want to come to practice there are ready to come.
Sounds absolutely first class. Meanwhile, 2 points each here.
You see Tong Yike is using a little bit this system, like not to playing too close this backhand, but like stepping back a very, very little bit and having more time for swinging and using the backhand, then it's difficult for even the good block of Wang Yichen to keep control there.
Let, two, three.
Let's serve. Ball just caught the top of the net. But again, Zhang Yike coming right across the table to return with the backhand from the forehand side. We're seeing a lot of that particular technique.
Yeah, good idea there, directly from Wang Yichen. Like long service in the backhand in order to stop Zhang Yike playing this backhand flip above the table.
Superb play by three times world champion Wang Yichen.
And that's classic, waiting for this ball in the backhand directly after turning around and using full power. No way to catch that ball.
3 points each. And just going back to the Werner Schlager Academy briefly, Richard, of course, it's what the game needs, isn't it? Europe to get stronger, whether it be German players, Swedish players, English players, so that the gap between Europe and Asia, we can just make it a little bit more interesting. We've got Timo Boll coming up shortly, but we do need more players coming through, don't we, for sure, for the sport.
Yeah, definitely. That's our goal, but that has to be the goal for everybody, not only to see at the last days of the World Championships only Chinese player. I think also that's interesting more for the Chinese player. They want to compete with other European players, with other nations, not to only compete with each other, and that should be the goal for international table tennis, for sure.
Zhang Yike now 1 point ahead. 5-4.
Net 4-5.
One fast serve into the backhand. Zhang, of course, that serve is a double-edged sword. It stops Zhang Yike coming round and using the backhand technique when it's short on the forehand. And it won the point as well. Yeah. So it has a not only wins the point, but it's a tactical blow for Zhang Yike.
And usually Zhang Yike stays there with backhand. You can wait there. That usually is not so early stepping around.
That was the reverse action service, as I would call it, the bat going away from the body, underneath and around the ball, backspin, side spin.
Usually one speciality of Timo, we will see further on. Zhang Yike is using this service very, very often. He liked that as well, because after this, he's usually ready to playing backhand.
Six,
little bit with edge, but like you can see directly, like Wong Yichin also, after one topspin diagonal, he's trying to switch this ball parallel to avoid this topspin in this diagonal side, which I think usually he would win also from this forehand against forehand. We'll see if he's risking one more long service there.
Oh, great play by Zhang Yike. He still had the time to get across, return it with the backhand as we saw there, and then switch it down the line.
Many other players would have probably turned around directly and using the forehand counter topspin, so he stays there, he feels good with backhand, he wants to use the backhand to finish that ball.
Great counter topspin. Zhang Yike threw the ball up with the backhand topspin, as we see here. But what a great topspin, top of the bounce, maybe just before the top of the bounce, racket over the top of the ball, elbow, wrist. Super shot. And the score's level, 7 points each. Could be disappointed there. He moved his feet well, he got into position. But he overhit that topspin. Yeah.
And service jumped out a little bit. So this spin of Wong Yichin for sure is not easy to counter topspin that ball. And Wong Zhang Yike for sure is not happy, especially when his service going out half long. He has this problems from time to time.
Two topspin errors. 9-7. Wong Yichin 2 points away from leveling this quarter final at one game each.
This is what usually you say quite often to Zhang Yike at this moment. Like he's a little bit up and down, like missing some, let's call it easy, and winning some big points there at the same time. So now he was a little bit like 4 points in a row where you really feel service was half long after this one more forehand miss. Now really not in the game. This happens still to Zhang Yike. He's still young. He still needs to lose, to not lose concentration. What happens still a bit too often.
There we see confirmation of that second game, 11-7 for Wang Lichin. And now this quarterfinal evenly poised at one game each. And certainly Wang Lichin looked very strong at the business end of that second game. As my co-commentator Richard Prowser said, it was 7 points each and then a couple of errors from Zhang Yike. And then it's one game apiece. So this game very much in the melting pot now. Personally, I would find it difficult to predict.
Yeah. It's really, the question for me is, like, what kind of thoughts Liu Liang have right now? Like, really, like, he should trust these young guns who are really coming and really are very, very strong, or he should rely one more time on Ma Lin, on Wang Lichin for 2012. Difficult decision, very difficult.
It's really tough.
First game.
And I'm sure the old boys want to get it even more difficult for Liu Liang.
We were talking yesterday about the Moscow when the Chinese women's coach Shi Shihao played the two young girls in the final in Moscow, and they lost to Singapore, and he played Liu Shiwen and Ding Ning, and they performed not as well as he would have hoped, but the experience they gained, they're back here literally 12 months later, and probably the two best players, certainly two of the best three players that I've seen here.
Yeah.
They played each other in the semi-final. It was an amazing game, and Ding Ning won 4-2 against Liu Shiwen. But they've delivered back for the coach, haven't they? But it's high risk. You're not going to do that in the final of the Olympic Games.
Yeah, exactly.
That's where it's a different selection, I feel.
Yeah.
So Zhang Yike leads 2-1 in the third game. One game each, of course.
Let. One.
Still
two.
Sticks to this backhand flick, also from short forehand side. Wants to open the game. A little bit different system than maybe Marlin would have had, like to play one more time short to really have chance directly off the table to start the game.
So in your time coaching the German team, is there one Chinese player who sticks out as the best? Or
yeah, at that time, to my point of view, the biggest trouble was caused by Marlin. It was really so difficult to play against him. Also, on the other hand, also when I remember 2006 in Germany, in China against Germany at that time, Wang Lichin was really at his peak and was really also so difficult to beat him. Also, he was easier to play because he was playing a little bit more the European style. But, well, this Chinese generation is really altogether a quite strong generation. Otherwise, they wouldn't have survived that long.
Sure. So 4-1, good start in this third game by Zhang Yike.
Let 4-1.
Net serve.
Again, half long. But he has to take care a little bit, not to keep on this service, this reverse service that's coming out too half long. Then usually it's possible to attack Zhang Yike directly.
2-4.
To backhand, yeah. Wang Lichin wins.
And more powerful of Zhang Yike, and Wang Lichin just put back the ball with a little bit height inside, so the ball is long and not so easy for a backhand player when he doesn't want to step around using the forehand to accelerate with the backhand. Maybe we see this one more time.
5-3.
Yeah, the ball was too short of Wang Lichin. It's easy for a good backhand player like Zhang Yike is to accelerate there. Main thing is if you play backhand, not to stay at the same time, not to always to switch timing a little bit and to make sure the ball is long enough, as close as possible to the white line. Again, half long
serve.
Cannot be happy with that.
Not at all. And now Zhang Yike 5-4.
What about changing service a bit? And he's changed there.
Zhang Yike goes for the forehand topspin. It catches the top edge of the bat and flies out of the court. 5 points each. Let's not tempt fate too much, but let's say Timo did manage to win against Chen Qi. It's 50-50, I think.
Yep.
Of these two players, is there anyone he's got a better record against?
I think against Wang Lichin he has quite good record, but Wang Lichin, the way he's playing here, he's really also showing that he's still around. Against Zhang Yike, also he in the last season, he win one time, he lose one time, so I think for him doesn't get so big difference, but for sure in case he should win against Chen Qi, would be also a 50-50 match against Wang Lichin and against Zhang Yike as well.
So we don't need to support one of the Chinese, but we'll take any of them. That's excellent to know. 6 points each.
Quite some backhand we see here. And really Wang Lichin can keep this backhand. Not too bad changing the timing there. Zhang Yike is always trying to accelerate there with the backhand. I wonder if one of these guys starts turning around, but of course then they are afraid that these balls coming directly down the line.
That's excellent stuff. Backhand to backhand. Wang Lichin steps round. It's almost like a training drill. Steps round, drills the ball down the line. Here we go, backhand to backhand. Round he goes. And on the diagonal, out wide to Zhang Yika's backhand.
Seven. Coming back to the reverse service. Not easy to predict who will be finally left superior there. Ball before, Wang Yichun was stepping around, very strong backhand, forehand from backhand side. Now good forehand after this not too bad flick of Wang Yichun.
Thank you. 7-0.
Zhang Yike has to be careful a little bit, not to let Wang Yichun step around too easily. Has to be ready to switch this ball down the line or maybe to open a little bit more for short or deep forehand. Not to rely on this backhand too much.
20.
Zhang Yike overhitting the forehand topspin. And Wang Yichun now leads 9-7.
This ball, again, I mean, I might be mistaken, but the arm is a bit slow of Zhang Yike. There was a chance there for switching the ball down the line, parallel, and it was really like arm a bit shaky there.
Strong play from Zhang Yike. Forced Wang Yichun away from the table, took the top spins quite early, the winner.
Very early, the ball.
Hits the top edge, flies off the end. Brave top spin from Zhang Yike. But still, Wang Yichun leads by 1 point, it's 9-8.
See on which service he relies there.
Block very low over the net from Wang Yichun.
Doing some bad decisions so far, like playing like on really high level, as this last ball was shown. But then a little bit like strange decision there, when to play forehand, when to play backhand. To my point of view, Wang Yichun feels more relaxed, and Zhang Yike is a bit nervous here.
Zhang Yike goes for the backhand down the line. It catches the top of the net, off the end of the table. And Wang Yichun wins the third game, 11 points to 8. Now leads by 2 games to 1. And I do agree, Richard. Zhang Yike there making a few strange choices, looking slightly shaky.
Yeah, and it's a little bit the same as it was in the second game, when it was 7-7, and we really saw Zhang Yike losing 4 points in a row very, very fast. And this happens now a bit like this in the end of the third game. I mean, a very good ball from Zhang Yike to the 8-9. But then again, you feel Wang Yichun is a little bit calmer, starting to turning around, using the chances a little bit more, and not missing the... It's not easy because they are like on so high level, but not if he has chance, he takes the chances. And Zhang Yike just misses some chances.
No, I agree. And whenever I've probably watched him 4 or 5 times, and that's been the case all the time. Clearly, there's an enormous potential there. I mean, it's a daft thing to say when he's number 3 in the world, but he could be better, couldn't he, if he could just...
Yeah, like, he's a little bit missing this control and from time to time, and really to judge when to play really this extra speed or when to play this extra spin or a little bit more control.
Long fast serve from Wang Yichun. Just goes off the end of the table. First point to Zhang Yike.
What worked at last point at the last set should work as first point in this game as well.
Zhang Yike there holding his ground. Again, taking that forehand topspin early. Out wide to Wang Yichun's forehand, wins the point.
In all three games, Zhang Yike had the better start. And then at the end, like, Wang Yichun start to catch up more and more. We'll see if what is going, which direction in the fourth game.
A short push. And Zhang Yike just falls on the wrong side of the net. Didn't quite have the touch to pull it off. He was trying to keep it very close over the net. 2 points each. Backhand topspin wins the point for Zhang. Forehand to forehand topspin, and this time Zhang Yike who comes out on top.
You see, and again, first ball he was ready a bit more for backhand.
Changed his mind.
Yeah, changed his mind fast enough. Also his position, you see from the legs, a little bit more like this parallel position, preferring more the backhand than the forehand. Usually with forehand as a right-hander, your right left, your right leg is a bit more behind and not in the parallel position.
Four, three.
Backhand topspin, just over hit. Trying to get the backhand out wide to Wang Lichin's forehand. Again, overhitting the backhand topspin, 4 points each.
You can tell he's not that happy right now. Like, doesn't find the right rhythm, maybe still not stays calm inside. And for sure not happy losing, being 2-1 down.
4-5.
Zhang back in the lead, albeit by 1 point, 5-4.
Oh.
Very good. Relentless top swings from Wang Lichin.
And you see how fast Wang Yichin was moving there. Another time turning around, see at that swing. And also showing Zhang Yike, I'm the boss in this box. I tried to take that point. Showing him the fist.
That's the point I was making before, and he was doing that against Zhu Zin at time. It's not aggressive, it's not nasty.
Yeah, it's not against,
like,
but it's like showing I'm here, I show my presence.
Correct. Six points each.
Five, seven.
And both players take the opportunity to use the towel, as they are fully entitled to do so.
Not that long rallies we have here. It's a little bit more like service return, playing this sometimes back and back, and then from time to time, of course, longer rallies, but really it's so much tactics behind, I think.
Five, seven.
Quite a few errors by Zhang Yike. That's why the game's not really flowing as well as perhaps we thought it might. The crowd a little bit down at the moment.
Got it. Oh. Eight,
a couple of good rallies would soon warm them up. Not far off a full stadium. There are empty seats, but there are a lot of people standing in the corridors around the stadium. I suspect if everybody sat down, it would be very close to full.
Nine, a bit luck there. See, this is again this crucial point where in the second and third game, Wang Lichin took his chances. Now this luck favors a bit Zhang Yike.
Wang Lichin almost made the backhand. Danny Heister.
And now the coach of Borussia Düsseldorf, Danny Heister, since this year. Yeah? doing a good job there.
Some great players have played at Dusseldorf.
Yeah, right.
In my time, Desmond Douglas from England had a good spell there. York played at
long time. Samsonov played there. To my point of view, really best club in Europe. Very professional club. See again. End of the game. Again, long service of Wong Yichin, trying to avoid the short return from forehand side with backhand of Zhang Yike. And Zhang Yike is not that aggressive on this long service in the back end. Gives Wong Yichin the chance to follow with a very strong forehand topspin after.
8-9, second serve of Wang's. Oh, and then a service error. What a time to do that. Zhang Yike now with 2 game points to level this quarter final at 2 games each. The crowd lifting the players. The reverse action serve. Unfortunately, didn't go on to win the point. 1 game point save, 1 remains. Action served, a little bit of backspin came underneath the ball, the flick into the net, and that's the 4th game, 11-9 to Zhang Yike.
I think also still at the end, Zhang Yike was in that way, again, a little bit hesitating there. You had this forehand miss there, and we had one more, like, 2 forehand misses there, and Wong Yichin helped him a bit, like one service return to the net, 1 service mistake, 1 little bit lucky ball, touches the net in favor of Zhang Yike. So still was there. I think Zhang Yike was a little bit more dominant throughout this game, but at the end, Wong Yichin catched up more and more and more. And you're more than right. Not the right flow right now. It's like a little bit like always 1 point ahead of each other. It stays tight, like quite some easy mistakes, quite some service return mistakes there.
But it's certainly the area from Zhang Yike's point of view where there's still a question mark. It's just selecting the right shot at the right time.
Exactly. That was good.
That was the right selection.
That was the right selection, yeah. And you see, at the last moment, we see in slow-mo, decides to play this ball in deep forehand, a little bit helping with the body, like a fake movement there.
One top spins from Zhang Yike to win the point. Wang Lichin now with his 2 serves.
Lock 2. Lock 2.
Oof. What a great return.
And change of return. Yeah? And this time usually using the forehand. Usually I think he never used that forehand like Malong did sometimes against Marlin to open the flick directly in deep backhand of deep forehand of Wang Yichin. Usually he prefers this backhand flip and not too much the forehand flick.
Zhang Yike varied the pace there, tried the softer one to break the rhythm. But bang, Wang Lichin took the ball, top of the bounce, straight through it.
It was a bit short, a bit too slow, but it was a good idea from Zhang Yike to change timing, not to keep the same.
Let 3-1.
Two strong backhand topspins from Zhang Yike. The second one caught the top edge of the bat of Wang Lichin.
In good position. Like at this half distance position, really Zhang Yike has time to swing and no way for Wang Lichin to take out that ball.
Good angle from Wang Lichin out wide to the backhand of Zhang Yike.
This time tried to avoid backhand block, trying to come directly with his forehand counter topspin. Shouldn't rely too much on backhand, should keep on doing backhand, but not rely too much. At the end of the third game, he was also stepping around, using a little bit more forehand. That should be the way from side of Wang Lichin.
Zhang Yike shakes his head. He had a chance to make the counter topspin. Backhand to backhand, but it's Wang Lichin. Strong forehand into the forehand of Zhang Yike, who takes on the counter topspin, quite out of the control. And Zhang Yike will be disappointed with that one. There was a good opportunity there to make that forehand topspin.
Good change of return, this time like pushing with backhand, not only flicking, but then again, this nearly an unforced error with forehand. Like these are little things he really has to keep on working there, not to miss these chances.
Let 4-0.
Again, that reverse action serve coming around the side and underneath the ball. Side spin, back spin into the net from Wang Lichin. 5-4. Zhang Yike leads. Second serve coming up.
4-6.
Again, the back spin on the ball. Two errors on the return of serve. Wang Lichin. Now he has his two serves to come.
Nice block of Zhang Yike. And he opens again this with a backhand flick and then stayed at the table. Wang Lichin turn around, you see this, nearly artistic. And with straight block that time, not with topspin because it was a last chance, like last extra reaction.
Backhand topspin down the line. From Zhang Yike, caught the top of the net, flicked it off the end of the table. And the score now 7-5 for Zhang.
And again, this variation of serves, Wang Lichin is doing quite okay, quite clever. Zhang Yike has really some troubles with this little bit surprising long service in backhand side. Missed quite some in the opening.
Zhang Yike, two serves to come. This time it's a little bit of topspin on the serve. That's the advantage of the reverse action serve. Very, very, I wouldn't say easy, but you can vary the spin on the ball by just varying the point of contact slightly.
It's a bit high also. I think Wang Lichin was surprised there. He should have gone for that ball, like fast flick maybe. A little bit hesitating.
Got it! Five,
but you're right, on like so much spin inside, like really Wang Yichen cannot find way. So I agree, this service mistake, this return mistakes really helps Zhang Yike now a lot.
I think that's four on the run.
Yeah.
Direct points on return a serve.
Let 5-9.
And those 4 points mean 9-5 in favour of Zhang Yike. And that's five game points.
Ten, six.
Too many serve mistakes, opening mistakes. At this moment, not their best table tennis.
And the topspin to topspin, forehand rally. Zhang Yike wins the point, wins the fifth game. 11 points to 6. And Zhang Yike now leads by 3-2. Confirmation of the situation in this men's singles quarterfinal. They've been playing for 44 minutes. Zhang Yike there, the number 3 seed. Wang Lichin seeded 9-16. But he is in fact the number 9 player in the world. But there he is, Zhang Yike, leading by 3-2, edging his way to victory, Richard.
Yeah, and doing very well with his service. I mean, he also had some trouble sometimes controlling the service. Service got out half long, but in the crucial moments, he did like 4 points in a row with his service, forcing Wang Lichin directly to return mistakes. Quite some spin, more spin than you expect. And here you see speciality of Zhang Yike, very strong backhand flip, followed by forehand. You see again, from a little bit middle, coming with backhand there, and then we have the forehand block, which not so many players play anymore, just like as a, nearly like an accident.
So the players now back at the table, and there's Timo Boll
preparing for his match with the German physiotherapist. David Schmidt, for sure, prepared him very well.
And the crowd have seen Timo on the big screen, and the applause starts straight away. And he's not even out on the court yet. Wang Lichin takes the first point. One love.
Oh, very nice, very nice, very well prepared.
Fantastic forehand topspin to win that with the side spin as well. Just have a look how the ball curls out wide.
And even Wang Lichin cannot reach that ball. You see, you were right what you mentioned before. See, a little bit slower topspin in between, really have patience and really finish that ball when it's really safe to finish it, not to rush it too much.
Concentration there from Wang Lichin. But the backhand topspin goes into the net. He didn't quite get the contact between bat and ball, brushed it too much, a very fine contact. The ball almost dropping off the bat. Zhang Yike now leads by 2-1. Of course, one more game would see him into the quarterfinal. Wang Lichin has to win the next two.
I mean, if the rallies are going, I think they're both quite equal. Just like in this last game, Wang Yichin had so much trouble returning the service of Zhang Yike.
Two, three.
And it's still not a game from longer rallies. It's like a little bit more tactic change of service.
Few empty seats that you can see, but lots of people standing in the areas at the back of the seating, so probably a capacity crowd here enjoying the men's singles quarterfinal. This is the third men's singles quarterfinal. It's 3-2 for the gentleman on screen, Zhang Yike, and it's 3-3 in the sixth game.
Wang Yichin, one thing he shouldn't for sure do, he should not hesitate, he should go for the ball, because that's his chance whenever he starts moving well, when he starts being inside the game, like moving with forehand, blocking one or two balls and follows with forehand.
Three, five.
Yeah, it's that reverse action serve.
Yeah. He's hesitating, he's not sure, he might think a little bit more upspin this time, because the last moment of the movement, it's up. But there, the ball has already left the racket. So in the moment when he's touching it in this reverse, like downspin action.
Good spin from Wang Lichin. Zhang Yike just not quite getting the racket sufficiently over the top of the ball to counter the spin. And Zhang now 5-4 in the lead. Interesting to see the two Chinese youngsters in the shot a while ago sitting together. Ma Long, Zhu Zhen. Not sure what they'll be thinking
four,
at this point in time.
Five.
Please, do they want to win this?
Four, five.
Good backhand from Zhang, 6-4.
And Wong Yichen is doing, to my point of view, the right thing, trying to turn around. Just this backhand was a bit too strong, a little bit also in deep backhand of Wong Yichen, even for Wong Yichen, difficult to turn around. I try to avoid a bit more this backhand cross, a little bit more from this forehand cross would be probably the better part for Wong Yichen. That's the right way. Try not to stay there with the backhand. Try to step around, try to go for the ball. And even if it's a chance for Zhang Yike to play the ball with backhand down the line, that would mean that Wong Yichen takes this risk. He's ready there.
Down the line, you can see how pumped up Zhang Yike is. This means a lot to him.
A nice adjustment of the ball. Was a little bit luck for Wong Yichen, but the ball jumped that higher. Maybe it got it even easier for Zhang Yike to follow that ball.
Five, seven.
5-7. Return error. Trying to get the angle out wide to Wang Lichin's forehand. So Wang Lichin now 1 point adrift. 6-7. One serve remaining.
Timeout.
And it is Zhang Yike who calls a timeout. Both players get the opportunity once in this match to do so. Zhang Yike now, it's clearly a pivotal moment in this quarterfinal. It's getting towards the business end of the sixth game. And of course, Zhang Yike needs to win only one of the remaining two. Interesting call, timeout.
Yeah, I mean, I think Zhang Yike really feels like it's coming a little bit more to the end of the sixth game, and he really wants to take this game, because he felt he's quite superior, because Wong Yichen has problems in service and return. And then 7-5, he rushed a little bit too much. Return of Wong Yichen service, to my point of view, there's no need to rush that. And probably he wants to calm down, because he knows if he takes the next point after having own service, he hopes to have the chance to have maybe a 10-6 lead there. Very important moment of this sixth game.
And the crowd have settled down. Wang Lichin to serve. 7 points each.
Second time rushed a little bit too much with his backhand. 7-5, 7-6, this backhand flick, net out, and then after a good forehand return, missing directly with the backhand. A little bit too fast, a little bit rushing, as I said, I think he's right now doing.
Zhang Yike there throwing the topspin up into the air, deep into the backhand of Wang Lichin, 8-7. Interesting to see now, Richard, whether he can maintain his composure, his rhythm, and not make the errors that he's made in previous games. And it's interesting, Wang Lichin's in with the timeout now. Of course, for him, this is a do-or-die situation. He can't afford to lose this game, he's out. So he's 7-8 down.
Interesting to see also this 7-7, and after the reverse service again, Zhang Yike started to attack, not with the backhand, but with forehand, and not with very fast topspin, but with a little bit slower topspin, very long. So Wang Lichin had to adjust his backhand block a bit more. And, well, it was not too bad a change of timing of Zhang Yike there. And we'll see what kind of ideas Wang Lichin got with himself out of the timeout.
So both players now back at the table. I'm sure this very knowledgeable crowd will see the players out there And indeed, as you can hear, the applause. And there's Timo Boll in the background, Chen Qi in the foreground. They're waiting. They're the next game on. What a point! What a point! Backhand to backhand, top spins, four of five. It was Zhang Yike who was generating all the speed and spin. Wang Lichin staying up to the table. And then Zhang Yike in with that forehand top spin. Wang Lichin just top spins off the end.
Very, very, very good. And he followed after with forehand. Before he used to miss two, three times, but now in this long rally he was really there. And look how is he enjoying himself. He knew it's a very, very important point and a very important situation right now.
7-9, two serves now for Wang Lichin. And he comes around, returns it with the backhand, and Wang Lichin, forehand topspin. He went to the exposed backhand side of the table, but he overhit. Three match points for Zhang Yike. And of course, he will have two serves to come at the end if he loses this point. Forehand topspin down the line. Great shot by Zhang Yike. He wins the sixth game. 11 points to seven. And he wins this quarterfinal by 4-2. All in all, best player won, Richard.
Yes, I think. Like, Wang Lichin really took all the chances he had, especially in the second and the third, to have a 2-1 lead. And then I think finally, to my point of view, Zhang Yike was the more complete player. And still a lot of credit to Wang Lichin. He did a good performance there. I'm sure he would be not too happy to lose this game, but